has given us that authority. Amen. But how much of Jesus you have in your heart and your mind will determine how much authority you will carry on. Because our authority is not of ourselves. It's from Christ. Christ. See more of Christ. The Old Testament talks about Christ. New Testament is about Christ. New Testament is hidden in the Old Testament, and the Old Testament is revealed in the New Testament. The New Testament is in the Old Testament concealed, and the Old Testament is in the New Testament revealed. Christ was in the books of the Old Testament. The first five books of the Bible, Christ was there in typology. In the books of history, he was there in pictures, in snippets, people's lives. He was like David. If you look at the Bible, everything there testifies of Jesus. That's why Jesus said in Luke 24, when he was walking with the two disciples, the Bible says, as Jesus walked with them, and starting from Moses and all the prophets, he expounded unto them in all scriptures the things concerning himself. So there was an amazing Bible study that Jesus did with those two guys. He started from Genesis and ended where he could end. And the Bible was saying that Jesus was teaching them about himself from the Old Testament. He was the seed of the woman in Genesis. He was the Passover lamb in Exodus. He was the pillar of fire by day and the pillar of cloud. He was that one in the book of Numbers. In Deuteronomy, he was the prophet like Moses. In Leviticus, he was our high priest. Jesus was all over the scriptures. And when you enter into the New Testament, Jesus is portrayed in the four gospels. Because of his greatness, he could not be described by one book. Think about it. God is so economical in writing the Bible. He will not waste words. So why would he allow for the story of one man to be repeated by three different writers or four different writers? Why? It's because he's too big to be contained by one book or by one account. Because they were describing his great aspect of Jesus. Jesus was presented by Matthew as the king. That is why, as a king, he must be introduced. So there was the genealogies given in Matthew. And it started from Abraham. And he said that the son of Abraham, the son of David, and traced it down to Jesus. Because as a king, he must be introduced. So if you want to know more about what Jesus said, read Matthew. But if you want to know more about what Jesus did, read Mark. Because Mark is an account of Jesus, but as an account of Jesus as a servant. So let me give you an example. In the boat, when he was crossing over, in the book of Matthew, they went to him and said, "Master, we perish, save us." But in the Mark account, they went to him and said, "Hey, careth not that we perish." Hey. Because they considered him as a servant. When you read the book of Mark, Jesus is presented as a king. But when you read the book of Mark, he's presented as a servant. You see, he's presented as a lion in Mark, but like an ox, a laborious beast of burden in the book of Mark. But in the book of Luke, he's presented as a man. Because Jesus was both God and man. So in Luke, which was written by a physician,
that's right,
because he knows human beings very well.
That's right.
He wrote about Jesus, and there was no introduction, no genealogy. Because as a man, no. His introduction in Luke was traced to Adam to prove that he was a man. Because Adam was the first man. It was in Mark that no genealogy was given. Which means that this guy is just a servant. We don't need to introduce yourself. But John starts like this. In the beginning, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was showing that this man was the Son of God, as Matthew was showing that Jesus was a king, and Mark was showing that Jesus was a servant. Luke was showing that he was a man, and John was showing that he was a Son of God. And as a Son of God, you've got to prove he is the eternal one. So as he starts his book, he said the beginning was the Word.